Right, let's pray for our government.
Thank you, Jesus.
See, I didn't say it. I was told not to say they really need it. We just got to pray. Okay, Father, we just thank you that we are blessed in this nation.
Amen.
Lord, we pray that protection over our national anthem, that it will not be stolen from us by the secular world. For we declare, God blessed us because he looks over us and we uphold him. Jesus Christ is Lord of New Zealand. Amen.
Thank you. Even as you enter this year, says the Lord, there is double grace for resurrection. That which you have let, that which you have loosed and let die in your life, you are to raise it up again, says the Lord. That desire, that purpose, was not just yours, says the Lord, but it was given to you by me. It was a unity, a partnership with me, says the Lord. I give you the desires of your heart. You are to rise up boldly at this time, says the Lord. For this is a good year that you face. This is a good year that you are going into, says the Lord. This is a year of my destiny. This is a year of my purposes for you, my people. You are to be very bold and you are to stand for righteousness. You are not to lie down before the enemy. You will see the suddenlies this year, says the Lord. You will see amazing turnarounds and extraordinary things. For this is a year of new beginnings. This is a year of the resurrection life of Jesus in you, says the Lord. For it will manifest and break forth. For you will be unstoppable, says the Lord. Have courage, my people. Rise up. As I purpose for you, as I put that desire in your heart, as I gave you that purpose, as I ordained you to that purpose, says the Lord, you are to walk in it. You are to walk. These are days of victory, says the Lord. Do not listen to the world or the turmoil that's going on. These are end days, says the Lord. These are the end times. But these are great opportunity. Opportunity will come to you, says the Lord. But you need boldness and you need courage. It will not just fall upon you like apples off an apple tree, says the Lord. You have a part to play in it. You must stand up. Take your authority as the head of your house to pit. Where death has tried to reign, you are to declare resurrection life. You are to stand against it, says the Lord. I ordain you and call you to that purpose even afresh today, that you are to rise up. You are to be victorious. The battle is not yours, says the Lord, but you are ordained to enforce my victory that came through the cross. This is not hard for you, says the Lord, for you are to stop striving. And you are to move in faith, then your authority will work. But when you try your authority through your works, then it is your righteousness, not mine, that is operating. But you are to operate out of the righteousness which was gifted to you, says the Lord. You are to be who I called you to be, and who I have declared who you are. You are my sons and daughters. You are my favored ones. You are my fires in this community. You are my revival fire, says the Lord. You are my way of creating a hunger and a thirst for the successful life. You are my way, says the Lord. You are my purpose, hallelujah, to live a successful life, that many would see the goodness of the Lord upon you and desire it, says the Lord. For good days are in front of you and long life, says the Lord. And you are to walk in them. And you are to walk whole. You are to walk whole. Hallelujah. Healed and blessed with the Lord. For this is my purpose and my will for you, says the Lord your God. Be blessed, my people. This is an exciting year. This is wondrous times. These are amazing times. What I've been doing in the background, says the Lord, I've been setting it up for you. I've been setting up the nations of the world, actually, says the Lord. Even internationally, things are happening. Great revival. These are days of great moves of my spirit, says the Lord. Have a boldness. Step into it. Be part of it. Hallelujah. Amen. Says the Lord your God.